Hi students, in continuation to our previous module, let me further discuss about the human resource planning. The last module gave us the complete the picture about what is human resource planning, the purpose and aim of human resource planning. So it is all about to find out the right number, right kind, at right time, in a right place. So these are the main the purposes of the human resource planning. It is also retains and then attracts the right manpower, and then it is useful for the maximum use of the manpower, and at the same time it also helps the organization to keep expenditure under control. So these are the main background issues of manpower planning. So in this module we will try to understand the factors affecting human resource planning. So what are the factors which affect the human resource planning, and then with that, so the main the learning objective of this module is to know how various factors are affecting human resource planning in the organizations. Now let us look at one by one. So the factors, so organization HR policies on recruitment, promotion, succession management, and then career planning, retirement and workforce mixture, etc. So when we have our own HR policies, policies related to recruitment, promotion, succession, accordingly we have to plan our the human resources. So sometimes the recruitment policies to accommodate the local son of the soil, right? And sometimes we have to have a kind of the plan for succession. So in terms of career planning and then the career growth, so we have to keep in mind the career plan in one hand, and accordingly we have to just develop the HR planning. And further, if you just look at the retirement and then workforce, the mix, that the people who are actually there in the organization, all these are going to decide the human resource planning. So organizational values and then strategies also. So value in the sense, if it value longevity of employees, then the HR plan might adopt that as strategy to recruit and then promote from within. So if you have the plan, the value of the organization is to see that the humanitarian ground, and then don't terminate, or even it is not firing is so easy, and then the organization is so humanitarian oriented. In that context, so our HR plan is supposed to be different. So like that, it depends on the strategies and then value system of the organization. So these are the things affecting the HR plan. So then strategy is another important thing, like how does the organization intended to use the HR to achieve the business strategy. So it depends on the top management ideology, the value system, and the strategy long term and even short term. And then if an organization is pursuing diversification strategy, so then the HR plan should ensure that it is the prepared with the staff that can help the firm achieving its strategy. So for example, new organizing structure, recruitment and selection and training, accordingly so we have to develop, and then so the based on this the strategic orientation of the organization, we need to develop the HR plan, right? So further, if you just look at the factors, like a changing demographic factors, like more young and more old or more educated. So if the market of labor, the changes to more young and then more old or more women or more educated people, accordingly then the job description is different and compensation strategies are different. General way of working might have to be changed to suit these the groups. So depends on the labor market. So depends on the demographic factors that are there in the society. So we have to develop our human resource planning. The fourth one is the government policy also. Recruitment for the gender balance and sometimes deprived the communities and the backward communities and disabled employees, and then mandatory retirement age, the voluntary retirement. So based on the government policies and the government system, so we used to come out with various HR policies to meet the or to implement the government policies with regard to the manpower, right? So further, the last one is the fifth one, the type of people employed and then the task they perform. And organizations may not need to plan very far in advance for unskilled labor. since they will usually be in abundant supply. So accordingly, it depends on the skills availability and the skills that we required for the organization. So it depends on the this condition, certain high skilled the job requirement planning activities that project a year or two into the future. So it depends on that. We have to plan for executive replacement may need even 5 years ahead. So this is the way you can see the type of people employed, the type of people required for the organization. So according to that requirement, we need to plan human resources. So our planning is affecting by this kind of factor, right? With this, let me stop here, and then looking forward to meet you in the video 36. So thank you.